today we will cover a topic that comes under midwifery and obstetrical nursing. It is one of the high risk pregnancy. Increased maternal morbidity and mortality rate can be occur. The topic is multiple pregnancy. Normally in the pregnant uterus, one fetus will be present. If more than one fetus is present in the uterus, then it is known as the multiple pregnancy. Different types are there. Two fetus is known as twins. Three fetus is known as triplets. Four fetus is known as quadruplets. Five fetus is known as quintuplets. Six fetus is known as sextuplets. Commonest we can see twins pregnancy. Incidence in 1 in 7200 pregnancy we can see twins pregnancy, that is in India. Nowadays 1 in 50 cases also we can identify because of increased treatment of infertility and artificial reproductive technology. And 1 in 60,000 pregnancy we can find out the Siamese, that is the conjoint type of twins. 1 in 250 pregnancy, here we can see monozygotic type of twins pregnancy. And they have more complications of low birth weight babies, very low birth weight babies, and miscarriage. Then next we'll let us discuss about what is the etiology. Etiology, if you see, a major etiology is unknown etiology, and race, Negroes like 1 in 20 pregnancy, we can find out multiple. Next, higher age, advanced age, more than 30, 40 years, grand multiparity, more than 5 number of children, previous history of multiple pregnancy, any ovulation induction drugs for infertility treatment like a clomiphene citrate, gonadotropin, artificial reproductive technology like embryo transfers, and well-nourished women, tall women, and hereditary family history, any maternal side they have any history, then they can go with multiple pregnancy. Next, we will discuss about what are the varieties of multiple pregnancy. Two are there, monozygotic twins and dizygotic twins. Monozygotic twins, it is otherwise known as identical or univovular twins. Here, fertilization of one ovum with the one sperm and a single fertilized ovum or zygote will be formed. This zygote undergo twinning or cleavage, and equal number of chromosome cells will be formed, that is, and later developed into two fetus. This fetus will have the same characteristics and same sex, male male or female female, and they have same blood group, same DNA, single fused placenta can be formed. In ultrasonography they can see the lambda sign, and the thickening will be more than 2 mm. And the twinning or process can be happen in early and the later. If it is occurs 0 to 3 days, they can go with diamniotic dichorionic, 2 amnion, 2 chorion layers. If it is happening in 4 to 8 days, they can go with diamniotic monochorionic, 2 chorion, 1 amnion. If it is takes place within 12 days, that is 2 weeks, they can go with monoamniotic monochorionic, 1 amnion, 1 chorion. If it is takes place more than 12 weeks, then they can go with having of Siamese, that is conjoined twins. Head to head joint means craniophagus, chest to chest thoracophagus, then next abdominal is there joining omphalophagus, ischio ischiophagus, like different type of conjoined twins are there. Next we will discuss about dizygotic twins. Dizygotic twins, it is otherwise known as non-identical. It is the 80% and it is biovillar and fraternal. Fraternal, it looks like brother and sister. Here fertilization of two ova with two sperm in the same menstruation cycle of different sexual act or same, and this will later form like a two fetus, that is known as the non-identical twins. Here they doesn't have a same blood group, their characteristics will be differ. And here fused or double placenta and separate membranes, a separate umbilical cord can be seen. And in the ultrasonography, the thickening will be membranes less than 2 mm, and here T peak sign can be identified. Next we will see what is the diagnostic evaluation. Diagnostic evaluation, mainly history collection, physical examination, and general symptoms of the women. Women will have nausea, vomiting in the early trimester, abdominal enlargement, cardiopulmonary embarrassment like palpitation. They can have breathing difficulty due to the gravid uterus. Pressure symptoms can be happen. Increased fetal movement. Signs, abdominal signs, when we do the inspection, barrel shaped abdomen, a large abdomen, more strias will be there, and fetal parts, more fetal parts can be palpated, fetal movement, fundal height can be more than the gestational week, abdominal girth can be more than 100 centimeter at the term, and double head can be find out, 2 FHR with a distinct heart rate of minimum of 10 beats per minute. Ultrasonography, we can identify the what is the lie, what is the presentation, how many gestational sac, any vanishing sac, chorionicity, placenta, locations, hydromnias, these features can be identified. And we can go with biochemical tests like HCG, unconjugated estriol, and maternal fetal alpha protein can be. Any risk is there, amniocentesis, choroid synthesis, chorionic villi sampling can be identified. Next, we'll see what are the lie and presentation. Here both vertex or both breach, one breach, one vertex, one breach, breach and transverse, vertex and transverse, both breach, both vertex, and one transverse or another also transverse, like the lie and presentation of multiple pregnancy, that is mainly twins pregnancy. First, we will see what are the complications. In the antenatal period, they can have like anemia, preeclampsia, polyhydramnias, hypertension, gestational diabetic mellitus, they can go with miscarriages, malpresentations, preterm labor, like that complication. Next, in the natal period, intranatal period, fetal distress, then cord around the neck or tanglement, and interlocking of the twins. When the delivery, first twin is a breech, second twin is vertex, chin to chin locking and interlocking of the twins can be done. We have to sacrifice the one twin, or fetal disimpaction procedure can be done. And another thing is PPH, increased post-operative deliveries, uterine inertias, like that problem. And postnatal, we can see subinvolution of uterus, puerperal sepsis, lactation failure. Next, we will see fetal complication. Fetal complication, miscarriage, fetal loss. Here we can see the early fetal demise, that is vanishing twins less than 10 weeks. And next, we can see the fetal papyrus and compresses, that is death of the fetus in the second trimester. Another twin will get problem. What happened? The twin will go with disseminated intravascular coagulopathy and brain injury, hypoxia, infection, and death can be happen. Next one is twin to twin transfusion syndrome. Donor twin will be so much of anemic, low birth weight, and hypovolemic oligohydramnias. And the recipient twin will be hypervolemic, polycythemic, and polyhydramnias will be present. The birth weight also donor twin will be less. This will known as discordant weight. One fetus will be less weight, another fetus will be more weight. And next, intrauterine growth retardation will be there, asphyxia neonatum will be there, and twin arterial reverse transfusion. One twin doesn't have heart, another twin will have heart. One will act as a donor, another will act as a recipient. Like that, tie will be there. Then cord around the neck, fetal distress, fetal death, interlocking twins, congenital anomalies like microcephaly, macrocephaly, neural tube defect, like that problems can be find out. And Siamese twins, these are the fetal complication. Next, we will discuss about management. Antenatal, proper screening of the pregnant women, proper antenatal care, proper advice for the follow-up visit, regular follow-up visit, and diet counseling has to be given, because pregnant mother is more demand during multiple pregnancy. She need to take 300 kilocalories of diet and 60 to 100 milligram of iron, 10 milligram of extra folic acid had to be taken, high protein can be taken, and if needed they can go with the hospitalization, any high risk pregnancy is there, and they have to go with the fetal monitoring, maternal monitoring, close observation has to be done. And in the later 30 after weeks, if needed, they can go with corticosteroid therapy, antenatal period in order to prevent the in order to increase the lung maturations. And encirclage progesterone therapies can be done in order to sustain the pregnancy if it is needed according to the physician order. Next, intranatal period. Intranatal period we have to conduct the delivery as a normal vaginal delivery if doesn't have any problem. First vertex has to be delivered, and we have to ligate the cord. Cord clamp has to be done, and 8 to 10 centimeter cord has to be leave. And we should not give methergine, we should not give oxytocin. Second baby delivered, 30 minutes or 15 minutes duration can be observed. And when the second twin is delivered, we have to see what is the lie, and when the full contraction only we have to deliver. Second vertex means we can deliver as a normal, forceps application can be done. If it is a breech extraction procedure, if it is a transverse, external cephalic or internal podalic version can be done and delivered the baby. If interlocking twin is there, that management can be done. And after the delivery of the second twins, labeling of the babies and methergine and oxytocin. Third stage labor, active management of third stage labor, oxytocin, prostaglandin and proper neonatal care, neonatal ICU and placental observations can be done. Mother has to monitor for any postpartum hemorrhage is there. Next, we will see unfavorable conditions like a fetal distress, cord around the neck, contracted pelvis, malpresentation. Like that situation, we can go with the cesarean sections. As a nursing management, we have to assess the mother in the antenatal period, intranatal period and postnatal period. Close monitoring has to be run. Any risk is there, we have to record it. Insist counseling regarding the diet and reduces the anxiety. And we have to do a drill practices to take care of high risk pregnancy and to conduct the deliveries. So today class we have seen about what is multiple pregnancy, what is the incidence, what is the etiology and what are the varieties, monozygotic, dizygotic, what is the diagnostic evaluation, management and nursing role. So today I am signing off, Mrs. Nima. Miss Video, we will meet again. Thank you.